Good morning. We are people who must sing for the sake of our very lives. You are a God who must be sung by us for the sake of your majesty and honor.
And so we thank you for lyrics that push us past our reasons, for melodies that break open our givens, for cadences that locate us home beyond all our safe places, for tones and tunes that open our lives beyond control and our futures beyond despair.
We thank you for the long parade of mothers and fathers who have sung of you deep and true. We thank you for the good company of artists, poets, musicians, cantors, and instruments that sing for us and with us toward you. We are witnesses to your mercy and splendor. We will not keep silent ever again.
Please join me in an attitude of prayer. O God of the despised and rejected, open our hearts to your grace. Open our lives to all people. Open our eyes to see you in the stranger. Open our ears to hear your voice in the cry of the poor. Open our hands to serve you among the humble. Open our arms to embrace you in our enemy. Open our hearts to receive your grace. Amen. This morning, I welcome you to this hymn fest. The choir and all the musicians have done parts of this before on a Saturday evening, and so they were glad to be able to bring it back this Sunday morning. A lot of work has gone into this, and I hope you'll enjoy it. But this is not just about everyone up here. You all have a participatory role. There are no screens, so if you did not get a booklet, if you'd put your hand up, John will bring you one. So if you need a booklet, a bulletin, let him know. Everybody got one, good. I want you to know they have that so you can sing along, participate. You'll see the parts where you are to be included. There are a lot of other things happening in the life of the church, so I invite you to look in that booklet. It has some of the announcements. Check online, read your Friday email. But I invite you now to let the music fill you and for you to give it back as we sing praises to God and proclaim our faith this day.
Let us pray. May our eyes be open that we may see the needs of others. May our ears be open that we may hear their cries. May our hearts be open so that we may address their needs. Let us not be afraid to defend the weak because of the anger of the strong, nor afraid to defend the poor because of the anger of the rich. Show us where love and hope and faith are needed, and use us to bring them to those places. And so open our eyes and our ears that we may be able to do the work of peace. Please stand as you are able for the singing of the hymn.
from Worship and Song. Why do we have one church for blacks, another for whites, another Hispanics, another for natives, and another for Asians? And why do we have one church for professionals, and another for the blue-collar workers, and another for people living on welfare? This is not the way Jesus taught us to live. Jesus crossed all the boundaries of his day. May we learn how to work across today's boundaries. Gather your children of every color and social status into one glorious and unified congregation that points the way for the rest of our world.
When we are readers of justice.
Let our earth be peaceful. Let our hearts be hopeful. Let our hands be gentle for the love of God. Let our ways be mindful, mending what is hurtful, doing what is needed for the love of God. Let our lives be fruitful, beautiful, and playful. Every day be thankful for the love of God.
I'm going to invite our kids to come up. We have been working on a song for you all today. It's all about the fruits of the Spirit. So we've got some fruits that we're holding to as we sing our song. So scooch forward a little bit. So we've been learning the fruits of the Spirit in Sunday school for the last several weeks, and learning about how having all these fruits will help us have a more, like a stronger relationship with God, right? We know God a little better, don't we? Okay, so I hope you enjoy our Fruits of the Spirit song.
I don't want to play it.
That was amazing. You guys do a great job. Thank you. Have fun out there. They're going to their last Sunday school for summer, so have fun, guys.
Thank you.
Let us pray. We rejoice that we have been formed into one body, composed of believers of every race and nation. Salvation has reached to the ends of the earth and to all generations. We are glad that our voices will join those of many languages this day and every day to proclaim your praise. Accept our praise, purify our hearts, instruct us in your word, and visit us with your Spirit, that we will follow in all the ways of faith to the glory of God the Creator. Amen.
God of all things and all people, you accept also the prayers of our sisters and brothers in Africa, Asia, the Pacific, the Americas, and Europe. We are one in prayer. So may we, as one, rightly carry out your commission to witness and to love in the church and throughout the world. Accept our prayers graciously, even when they are somewhat strange. They are offered in Jesus' name. Please join me in the unison prayer. O Holy God,
open unto me light for my darkness, courage for my fear, hope for my despair. O loving God, open unto me wisdom for my confusion, forgiveness for my sins, love for my hate. O God of peace, open unto me peace for my turmoil, joy for my sorrow, strength for my weakness. O generous God, open my heart to receive all your gifts. Amen. Lord, we continue to pray, asking that you would be in this time with us, that a word or a tune, a note, would strike us deep within our heart where we know you reside, and that in that movement we would remember that you are holy, that you love us, that you are a God of peace. Remind us of those things in this space and beyond. Remind us that you are a generous God, that you offer us many gifts in this world. Help us to recognize them. But help us not just to receive, but to give. For there are many in this world who could use those gifts. No matter what they may believe, no matter what their system is, help them to know that we are instruments of your peace, people who share your love in this world. We come this morning, some of us hurting, some of us grieving, some of us anxious, some of us concerned. Pour out your spirit on each person gathered in this place. We pray for those who this day could not be with us, who are recovering, who are seeking you. Be present. We pray together the prayer that Jesus taught us as we say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
God of our daily lives, we pray for the people of this world working and without work, homeless or well housed, fulfilled or frustrated, confused and cluttered with material goods, or scraping living from others' leavings, angrily scrawling on walls or reading the writing on the wall, lonely or living in community, finding their own space and respecting the space of others. We acknowledge our sisters and brothers mourning and celebrating. We share their sufferings and hopes.
I invite you to stand as you are able to join in this prayer adapted from the prayer of Ignatius of Loyola. Teach us to serve as you would have us do, to give and not count the cost, to fight and not heed the wounds, to toil and not to seek for rest, to labor and not to ask for any reward. Accept the reward of knowing that all we do is your will. We commit ourselves to the necessary work ahead. Be present with us, work in us, and through us. You may be seated.
Thank you.
Renew your church, Lord, your people in this land. Save us from cheap words and self-deception in your service. In the power of your Spirit, transform us and shape us by your cross.
O God of the despised and rejected, open our hearts to your grace. Open our lives to all people. Open our eyes to see you in the stranger. Open our ears to hear your voice in the cry of the poor. Open our hands to serve you among the humble. Open our arms to embrace you in our enemy. Open our hearts to receive your grace. Amen.
Shine with the joy and the love of the Lord, we adore.
It is by our love that we become servants in the world. It is by trusting that we become fully human.
It is by changing that we hope to grow.
What we were when we came here, we will not be when we leave.
For we have met each other in the presence of God.
Change is bittersweet. In order to change, we are forced both to leave something behind and to embrace something new. Grant us the grace on this day to do both with humility. Help us to affirm the good things of our past as we lean into the future, where there will also be good things. As we contemplate who we are and what we can be, remind us that all good things come from you.
As the ushers come forward to receive our tithes and offerings, let us take time to reflect on these words as we contemplate looking at our own reflections in a mirror.
Thank you.
thanks for the gift of music, the gift of hearing it and experiencing it. And we give thanks for all of the gifts you give us and ask that you would continue to bless us as we use those gifts to serve you. Amen. I would invite you to stay standing as together we read the prayer of St. Francis. Lord, make me an instrument of thy peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life.
Please be seated. Lord, prevent us from falling into the sin of believing that the slavery of Egypt is better than the struggle in the desert.
Lord, in these times, when we fear we are losing hope or feel that our efforts are futile, let us see in our hearts and minds the image of your resurrection, and let that be our source of courage and strength. With that and in your company, help us to face challenges and struggles against all that is born of injustice.
Thank you.
Whether the word be preached or read, no saving benefit I gain from empty sounds or letters dead. Unprofitable all and vain, unless by faith thy word I hear and see its heavenly character. Unmixed with faith, the scripture gives no comfort, life, or light to see, but mean darker darkness leaves him plunged in deeper misery, overwhelmed with nature's sorest ills. The spirit saves, the letter kills. If God enlighten through his word, I shall my kind enlightener bless. But void and naked of my Lord, what are all verbal promises? Nothing to me, till faith divine inspire in speak and make them mine. Open my eyes to see thy face, open my heart thyself to know, and then I through thy word shall obtain sure present, the eternal gain.
Sit down, Arthur. It's still my turn. I'm so excited, too, because I love that song. How many of you have sung Oh for a Thousand Tongues to Sing before in your life? Well, I know you all have. Lots of us, because it is the Methodist anthem. The Methodist national anthem, if you would, only in England, but not really. But Oh for a Thousand Tongues to Sing is an amazing song, and I've been hearing it more and more as I listened to them sing it, as I heard you all sing it last. So 2 weeks ago, Kevin and I were at St. Simon's Island, which is where John Wesley spent time. Some of you may have been there. And there's a bell tower, and on the hour, it starts to chime, and then it plays, Oh, for a Thousand Tongues to Sing. And I thought, whoa, it played the first version, the Amazon version, not the ghost one, but cool. And I thought, wow, I'm so excited I get to talk about that again. And then I started doing some research on Oh for a Thousand Tongues to Sing. Charles Wesley, of course, wrote that. And the first Sunday it was ever sung in a church was May 21st. I know, that's today. 1739, but May 31st. Here we are celebrating whatever anniversary that is. Someone will do the math and tell me, I'm sure, but a long time ago, but May 21st. And the reason Charles wrote this song was he had had this amazing experience of God. And he looked through all the songs he found, and they were all stodgy. His word, not mine. And they were all based on Psalms. And he found them boring. We have some great songs based on Psalms now that are not stodgy. But he found that, so he wrote, started writing hymns. The hymnal has many Charles Wesley songs in it. We are people whose tradition is all about music. We are people whose tradition is about singing. You know, Brian has been teaching you throughout the months to sing in parts, to sing in harmony. You noticed maybe some of these you were asked to sing in harmony. We are people whose tradition says, do music and do it well. Sing out. And if you think you aren't great at it, it doesn't matter. Do it anyway. Right, choir, you're good at it. But you don't care if the rest of us don't do it great, as long as we try to sing out. Our hymnal and the faith we sing and the worship and songbook, everything we've sung today, every reading that Arthur and I have done, everything but the anthems are from our books, our worship books, our books of song. Because Charles and John both felt the only way that we could truly express our faith was through our music. Through our music. That's all of us, and isn't that exciting? To be able to do that, to give voice to things we maybe can't always give voice to answer God's movement in our hearts in a way that is powerful. Oh, for a thousand tongues to sing my great Redeemer's praise. Charles said that that is all we can do, and there would not be enough ways to do it, even if we had a thousand tongues. When he originally wrote this, it was 17 stanzas, and we only sang five. They're all in your hymnal, if you ever want to look, all 17 of them. Some are better than others. He might have been pushing it just a little bit to come up with 17. But it's one of those things he told us to do, to sing. We have a couple more songs left in this series today for this service, and I hope you'll sing them out as Methodist. You know, even Garrison Keillor talks about Methodist singing. He talks about how they might not be good at some things, but they can sing in four-part harmony. We grow up doing that. I don't know if that's true or not, but I remember as a child sitting in church and listening to my father sing. And he sang everything to the tune of "Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord." Everything. And he would be the first to tell you he could do that. He loved that song. You have not heard Silent Night till you hear it done to that tune. And I remember as a child, and he sang loudly, full of faith. And I remember as a child pulling his suit coat, because everyone wore a suit coat then, pulled his suit coat, he looked down, I said, shh, sing in silent tone. He didn't, luckily, because I've learned you just sing. You just express your faith. I hope for you all ways of doing that, to continue to sing out your faith, to share if you're gifted and talented, if you're just part of the congregation, you're not just. You're never just. Sing out, ring out, play out. Let the world know that you are singing praises to God. Amen.
Like an ant on a stick, both ends of which are burning, I go to and fro without knowing what to do. And in great despair, like the inescapable shadow that follows me, the dead weight of sin haunts me. Graciously look upon me. Thy love is my refuge. Amen.
You asked for my hands, that I might use them for your purpose. I gave them for a moment, then withdrew them, for the work was hard. You asked for my mouth to speak out against injustice. I gave you a whisper, that I might not be accused. You asked for my eyes to see the pain of poverty. I closed them, for I did not want to see. You asked for my life, that you might work through me. I gave a small part, that I might not get too involved. Lord, forgive my calculated efforts to serve you, only when it is convenient for me to do so, only in those places where it is safe to do so, and only with those who make it easy to do so. Forgive me, renew me, send me out as a usable instrument that I might take seriously the meaning of your call.
Meant to see with floods of wickedness overflowed with violence, wrong, and cruelty. One wide extended field of blood where men like fiends each other tear in all the hellish rage of war. As listed on Abaddon's side, they mangle their own flesh and slay. Tophet is moved and opens wide its mouth for its enormous prey. and myriads sink beneath the grave and plunge into the flaming wave. Oh, might the universal friend this havoc of his creatures see. Bid our unnatural discord end. Declare us reconciled in thee. Write kindness on our inward parts and chase the murderer from our hearts. Who now against each other rise? The nations of the earth constrained to follow after peace and prize the blessings of thy righteous reign, the joys of unity to prove, the paradise of perfect love. Please join in the responsive intercession. Let us ask the Creator God to sustain and guide us along the way to full unity.
Hear us, Creator God.
Let us ask the Lord for the gift of unity and peace for the world.
Listen to us, O God.
Let us ask the God of peace for the gift of unity and concord throughout the world.
Help us to do your will, O God of peace. We ask you, O God of grace, for the gifts of your eternal spirit. Enable us to penetrate the depth of the whole truth and grant that we may share with others the goods you have put at our disposal. Teach us to overcome divisions. Send us your spirit to lead to full unity your sons and daughters in full charity, in obedience to your will. Amen.
Please stand as you are able for our closing hymn.
the benediction and the postlude, I'd like to do some thanking. I'd like to thank the choir for doing this again, and you all sounded so amazing and wonderful. And some of you are new to the choir, and thank you for that. And for Fred for being here to play the violin, we appreciated that. The bells, how amazing. Arthur, as always, such a great reader, we appreciate that. Brian, for organ work and putting this all together. Elizabeth, I forgot you, but not really. And Elizabeth, for all her work, all that the music department did. And all of you for participating, for supporting, and being a part of the music of this church. Go from this place using 1,000 tongues to sing praises to our great Redeemer. Go in peace. Amen.